Hi, my name is Sanjay Gupta, and I'm a cardiologist and I work in York. Today I thought I'd do a little video on how to try and work out whether your breathlessness could be due to a problem with the heart or not. The first thing to say is that breathlessness is a very common symptom, and it's also a very non-specific symptom. When someone complains of breathlessness, it could mean a variety of different things. They could just be very unfit, a person could be overweight, and then they may have not realized that they've put on weight, and that's causing them to become breathless. As people get older, they don't actually realize, and when they take on some kind of physical activity that they haven't done for a little while, they notice breathlessness, and these are obviously, they don't signify a major problem at all. Then there are other causes of breathlessness, predominantly the lungs, and if you have a problem with your lungs, then that certainly could cause breathlessness, and that's more of a concern in people who are heavy smokers, or people who have a history of asthma, people who have been exposed to asbestos, and I suppose if you are getting breathless, then it is very important to at least have a chest x-ray, because if there's a problem with the lungs, then most of the times that could be the chest x-ray can give you some clues as to whether or not it is due to the lungs. After that, after having a chest x-ray, the next step would be to probably have some lung function tests. And in a small percentage of people, breathlessness could be due to small clots going up to the lung, in which case a CT scan of the chest would answer that question. From a heart perspective, though, there are two main things. The first is, the reason people get breathless because of a problem with the heart is that the heart is not able to pump out enough blood. And if the heart isn't able to pump out enough blood, then there's less oxygen that goes around, and that causes breathlessness. So the first thing to say is that you want to know whether your heart is actually structurally healthy or not. So as it is, whilst you're at rest, is the heart structurally normal or not? And the way one works that out is firstly to have an ECG and secondly to have an echocardiogram. What does the echocardiogram tell you? The echocardiogram tells you if you have a nice strong heart, if it's pumping at rest, if it's pumping adequately at rest, pumping enough to be able to pump enough blood out, commensurate with the body's requirements. It will also tell you, a scan will also tell you if you have a problem with any of your heart valves. A lot of the times, a heart valve problem is suspected when a doctor hears a murmur in a patient complaining of breathlessness, but sometimes you don't hear a murmur, and therefore if you are getting breathless, then undoubtedly it is important to have a heart scan. It's also worth saying that it is very, very, very rare for someone to get breathless at rest and not be breathless on exercise. So if you are getting that, then almost certainly that does not signify a major problem with the heart. Heart problems are usually worse on exercise than at rest. So if you have a normal heart scan and it shows that your heart is actually functionally normal and it's pumping normally, what is the other way that you could get breathless? I suppose if the heart isn't getting enough blood when you start walking, so on exercise when the heart isn't getting blood, then that would obviously cause the heart not to pump as well, and that would make someone breathless. And that's usually that usually happens if the heart arteries, the arteries that take blood to the heart, are narrowed, i.e. angina. So a lot of people associate angina with a chest discomfort, but in a few cases there could be the only symptom maybe of breathlessness. So I suppose if you are getting breathless, the first thing to try and work out is it at rest or is it on exertion? If it is at rest and not on exertion, then almost certainly it doesn't signify a major, major problem with the heart. If it is on exertion, then certainly I think you definitely need an ECG and a heart scan. And if your heart scan is normal, then your doctor will need to do a provocative test, i.e. get the heart beating faster to see if it's getting all the blood it needs to keep working. And that can be done by putting you on the treadmill, by doing something called a stress echocardiogram, or even something called a myocardial perfusion scan. Now, when the heart is weak, at rest, that condition is called heart failure, i.e. the heart is failing to keep up with the body's requirements, and that is usually something that we would suspect in people who have had a previous heart attack and therefore have had a damaged heart, or in people who have been born with a heart problem, so congenital heart disease. And the other thing to be aware of in people who have heart failure is they get other symptoms. They get exercise intolerance, they get breathless, they get very tired, and they often complain of swelling of the legs, swelling of the ankles. They find that they often have to sleep with more pillows than normal because they get more breathless if they're lying flat. In that setting, that's very suggestive of heart failure, and it's really important to get that checked out. And I suppose that's about it, really, for this tutorial, for this video. If you have any concerns, I think it's always worth getting checked out. If you would like to know more about me, what I do, and if you'd like to know more information about heart health and heart matters, then please feel free to visit my website. Alternatively, you could give me a ring on the following number if you would like to get checked out by a cardiologist. I'd be delighted to do so. And other than that, I think I just want to wish you good night, and thank you very much for listening. I hope this was useful. Bye.